everybody. My name's Walter, and today I want to show you my latest elevator design. It's a safe and modular up and down elevator. Now, modular means that you can have as many exits as you want. The only limitation here is that each of those floor levels of the exits have to be at least 10 blocks in difference height. Or otherwise the timing wouldn't be working. Now, what means safe? Okay, first what means up and down, that's pretty much self-explanatory. So if I stand here and press this button here, well, first I get pushed out because I was standing not right position, so now I can get upwards. As you can see, I get transported upwards exactly one module. Now I just have to press the button on the same side again and I can go up one block more, one module more. If I press the other button, I get transported downwards. And now what I mean with the safe part, you know, if you are transported upwards and go to one side, you get stuck. And usually what would happen next is you would fall, and probably if the height is enough you would die. Not with this one here. Because every time you go up, the elevator also goes after that slowly down, so the up and down features are pretty much combined, and you can't actually die in this elevator, which is really nice, especially on a server with a lot of lag spikes, where you rather often glitch through one of those pistons here. Okay, now what will you need if you want to build this one? Of course you will need some kind of building block, then some obsidian blocks, some glass blocks if you want to watch and see while you are being transported in this elevator here, then some glowstone blocks, some slime blocks, and for each module one redstone block. Then depending on the height of this elevator you will need sticky pistons and normal pistons, and quite a lot of them. Then normal redstone dust, redstone repeaters, and redstone torches, and again a lot of them. Then you will be needing buttons, for each module two, and some fence posts, for each module one, or to be more exact, for each exit you will be needing one of each. Now, how much space will you need? You will have to dig down one block, only one block here, and the space you will be needing is 6 blocks in width and 9 blocks in depth, because you have those little parts of the circuit here that are needed to, well, relay the signals to both sides. Okay, so now you know what you need and how much space you need. Now, just a little before starting with the building of this one, just a little advice, and that is, I already said that the distance between each of those exits must be at least 10 blocks. Another thing I would advise you is that it should be an even number of blocks, so that the buttons for going up will be on the same side and the buttons to go down will also be on the other side all. So you won't have to switch between sides if you want to go from the bottom one to the topmost one, for example. Okay, but that's enough for that, so now let's start with the actual building. So, as you can see, I already placed some platforms here where the exits of my elevator will be. Remember, the exits must have a minimum distance of 10 blocks height. So now, let's start with the bottom exit. For that, if this is the middle line of your elevator, go to this side here and place a normal piston facing upwards like this. Then take out this block here and place a normal block on top of it. And below another normal block, like this. Okay. Now, go out one and place four blocks in a row like this. Then go up one block, place another block here, then one block behind this piston here. Then you go down one block again and up again, like this. Okay. Now place a torch on the side of this block. Five redstone like this, then grab two repeaters, one here on the default setting, and another one here on two ticks, like this. Finally, put a button on top of this and block here, like this. Okay. Now it's time for the first segment of this elevator. Those segments are rather easy to build and will be stacked on top of each other until you're at the top. We will be building at first an elevator that goes from this floor here to the topmost floor, and later on we will be modifying the exits or inserting those exits in the middle. So now, how can you build those segments? First, you go back one block here and place a sticky piston facing towards you. Then you place a piston, a normal piston facing upwards, like this. Okay. Now you put some redstone on top of this block here, a normal block on this side, another normal block here. On this block you put a torch, then we go to the other side here, on top of this torch here we place another normal block, torch here, and another normal block here. Now we do the same, just mirrored, on top of this one. So, for that we place a sticky piston here, with a normal piston on top, in front of it, like this. Then we grab a normal block, put it here, another normal block here, the redstone, then the torch here, another block here, block on top of this, and another torch here. As you can see. And now those two levels here will be repeated on top of each other, so let's just make another one. So for that, those two here, this, so don't worry about this, you can just do it like this and it's going down again. Okay, then like this, here, and as you can see it's like a chess pattern here, so it's alternating between normal block, then some redstone, normal, redstone, and so on and so on. And if you activate it, you see a nice little sequence that will be transporting you upwards later on. Okay. You can already, if you want, fill in those holes here with some normal blocks. And it wouldn't hurt to put some kind of block down here. Okay. And finally, you can encase this here with some glass so you can see out of it, like this. And you can see I get transported upwards like a charm. Okay, now you just have to repeat these two layers here until you're at the top. And it should look something like this. As you can see, now I have a little elevator that goes from the bottom to the topmost exit, like this. Now, before you actually try out this one, I would advise you to first take out this one here and then place two obsidian like this, or those pistons down there might be pushing the pistons and blocks above them, which would, well, kind of destroy the elevator a bit. Okay, so now let's give it a little try. And if you stand right, come on, What's the matter here? Come on. Okay, now it's bad. So, and now as you can see, I get transported upwards until I'm at the top. Like this. Okay. Good. But you can also see there's at the moment no down feature, nor is this elevator safe. So what we will be building next is the down feature that's also kinda combined with the upwards feature, and so makes this elevator a safe one. So for that, go to the back and go to the first piston here, go back to blocks, place a torch on this block here on the side, then some redstone here, and a redstone repeater on one tick here, like this. Then do the same on this side here, so torch, redstone, then a repeater. Don't worry for if they combine, the next level will be cutting this layer here off. Then place a block here, go down here, place another block here, and place a repeater here on two ticks, and some redstone on top of this block here. Okay, so this is the bottom two layers. They are a bit different than the next two, than the next segments here. So what I've been, the next two levels here will be the ones you have to repeat until you're at the top. So for that, place two blocks here, two blocks here, then one block here, one block above this, one block here, and one block here. As you can see, we have this little chest-like structure again, and those blocks here. So redstone, redstone. Well, actually, let's start with the torches. Then redstone, redstone, some redstone here, some redstone on top of this one. Repeater here on two ticks, repeater down here on two ticks, repeater and repeater on one tick each. And this is the two layers that will be repeating until we are at the top. Okay. And now it looks like this. Well, let's give it a little try. So let's see. And as you can see, I get transported upwards. And as soon as I'm at the top, the downwards feature safely transports me downwards again. So what now is still missing are the exits in the middle and of course the top exit, and actually we'll be starting with the exit here at the top. Okay, first we have to remove a few blocks at the top here. So for that, first remove this obsidian block here, then place a sticky piston back here and a piece of glowstone in front of it, or another transparent block. The reason it should be transparent is otherwise, while you are going down, you get hit with this block at the last second in the head, and if this is a full block, you will get in survival a bit of suffocation damage, and that's something we don't want or don't need. So then, replace this obsidian block one block higher. Good. Now, this block besides this piston here is needed. So remove the torch and this block here. But this torch here is needed, so don't remove this one. Okay. Then, remove this repeater here. And then remove this block here. Actually, remove only the redstone on top. Now, remove this block, the torches on top of it, then this block here. This is the topmost piston on this side here with a normal piston in front of it. From this one, remove the block besides it and the two blocks below those. Then remove those two blocks here. Now, replace the three blocks besides the pistons here with obsidian, and replace the torch on the top one of those. Then go to the normal block below this one and place an upwards facing sticky piston besides it, like this. Then grab a few slime blocks and place them like this until it aligns with this piece of obsidian here. It should be 6 slime blocks. Now grab 2 pieces of glowstone and place them here and here, and put some redstone on top of those blocks. Then put a normal block here, another normal block here, put some redstone on top of those blocks, and put this repeater here on 2 ticks. Good. Now go to this side here, place some redstone here, then a block above it. On this block you place a torch, then a block on the side of it, like this, and a block on top of it. Then some redstone here, and you should see it lighting up. Now, a sticky piston on the side of it, facing towards this tower here. Then on top of the tower you place a redstone block. You should see now this gap here closing. And now we go to this corner here, diagonally from this extended piston here, and place a block above here. Put a button on top of it. Now a sticky piston facing downwards below it, with a normal block below it. Then leave a too high gap and put another normal block with a redstone torch on top of it. Then besides of the redstone torch, a normal block, one normal block further, then put some redstone on top of those blocks. Then 2 obsidian on the sides of this tower here, aligning with the redstone of the normal blocks here. Then another normal block here, then go up one with a normal block here. Place some redstone on top of this block. Then grab some repeaters and place them in a row like this. And that should do the trick. So if I now activate the button, as you can see, I get transported downwards without getting any damage. And now if I go up, you can see that those pistons here at the top will retract at the right timing, and I get finally transported to the top. And that's the top exit. Now it's time to build the exits in the middle. So now, to insert an exit somewhere in the middle of this elevator, first take out those 4 glass blocks here. Then go to the side with the piston one block above the floor level. And at the floor level, remove this block here with the 2 torches on it, like this. Okay, now take out this redstone here, those 2 repeaters here, this redstone here, then on this side this redstone here. And now again at the floor level, take out this block, one above this block. I would advise you to first take out this block here, like this. Next, replace this repeater here with a redstone wire. Put this one here on 2 ticks, then grab some glowstone, and replace this block here with some glowstone. Do the same here, and also with those 2 blocks here, remove this block here also. Then remove this block here and this block here too, and replace those 3 blocks here with some obsidian like this. Then place a torch on the bottom one here, and a sticky piston here, two blocks below, facing upwards. Then come on, grab your slime blocks and place 6 in a row like this, or in a tower like this. Then put some redstone on top of those blocks here. Another block here with some redstone on top of it, like this. Okay, put some redstone here, a block here, another block here. put some a torch on the side of this block, then above and on the side another block, redstone top of this block, steel piston facing towards this tower, then grab a redstone block and put it on top of the tower, then go to this corner here, again diagonally from the extended piston here and one block up, go below, place a upwards, downwards facing piston, stick piston with a normal block below it, leave a too high gap, place a normal block, redstone torch on top of it, besides the torch and one block, besides that a normal block, put some redstone on top of those blocks, then put a block of obsidian here and another block here, normal block besides the obsidian block, and then go up one block, put some redstone here, then three repeaters here and here, like this, then the downwards feature should be complete as you place the button here, should be complete, yes, it works as you can see. Now go to this side here, place a block with a button on top of it, then leave a one high gap like this, go around here, then one block up and one block more like this, put a torch down here, another torch on this block here, replace this torch to, okay, replace this block like this, okay, now put a repeater down here on two ticks, then some redstone here. Now we have to get the signal to the other side. For that, place three blocks here like this, put some redstone on top of those, let it run into this block here with a torch on the side of it, then a block above the torch, another block here, put a repeater on it on one tick, then another block here, a torch on the side of this block, and finally a block above it. And now if you push this button, you see it activates this whole segment, module of the elevator here. So now it's time to give it a little try as soon as this has retracted completely. So first let's test the downwards feature. And as you see, it works. Now the upwards feature from the module below works also, and now let's go up all the way, and as you can see, it works like a charm. Now we just have to do the same here at this level, and we will have our 4 level up and down, safe and well modular elevator here. And the elevator is done. As you can see, I added a few details. So here at the bottom I added another block here to make it a bit more symmetric. And also I added a few fence posts. So a normal one on this side here and a nether brick one here, so they won't combine. And I can, just by walking between them, align myself at the right position to walk up and to be transported upwards. One little suggestion I have is placing the normal fence post where the button on the side with the button that will be transporting yourself upwards, and the nether brick one on the side that will be for the downwards feature. So you can actually remember which side you have to press to go in a specific direction, since, well, the nether is supposed to be somewhere down there, and, well, wood needs light to grow, so you can remember this quite nicely. So now let's go up, and as you can see, it works nice. Let's go up another one, and finally let's go to the top, and as you can see, I already also built a little, at least a little ceiling here, and a few walls, and well, it's not the nicest looking thing I ever built, but I think it does the trick. Of course, the last thing you would have to do would be building a little wall around the redstone so you can see it. But nevertheless, that was how you can build my safe and modular up and down elevator. I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial, and well, see ya.